Welcome to Analytics with Nags. We're going to see two more transformations in data flows, that is multicast and conditional split. Without wasting time, let us jump into a demo. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for the notification. We have a solution file here that we have did a lot of basic transformation in our previous session. Let us try to copy this. How to copy? Copy and go here and paste it. Let us try to rename it V7 transformations. Let us keep it like that. And this is fine. Or we can say it like multicast. And that is conditional split. Conditional. That's enough. Okay. Too much name. That is okay. Multicast. Multi underscore condition. This is fair enough. Okay. Now we have this package. What we are going to do? So let us try to understand these two transformations. First, we'll start with multicast, right? So what is this? So we have now you can see this flow, the source and the target, right? We have one source and a target. Now what happens after doing all these transformations? You want to load it in another source, right? From this particular source, this is in one database, and the same logic whatever you implemented has to be loaded in another database also. So you no need to repeat the entire process. For that, just you can go and use the multicast. So what it does is like, it will, whatever output or input it receives, it will create multiple outputs of it, right? So let us see, I will point this one to multicast here, okay? Then I will have output over here. Then I can have another target as well. So what target? It can be a same database or same table, or it can be another database, another table. Let us try to load in this database. The target we have loaded last time is SSIS demo. Let us try to get that table script and try to load it in another database. So in this case, I'm copying the script and I'm using the test database as a target, okay, and create it here. Here you can see there is no data. Select star from here, okay, the sales data is over here. Now you can see here the database. There is no connection string created for that database, right? Target database. So let us try to create it. Let us try to create a new dot test database and click on OK. Click on OK. OK over here. Test database. Now the target comes over here. The OLDB destination. There you go. Now when I click on it, there will be list of options, three options. Where is your target? This target, test database. Click on it. Here it will list the table that recently now created, sales target. Now click on OK. So now you need to choose the columns here, because as we know, the column data types are not matched. The converted order type that we have done it in our previous video. Location chart, yes, this is fine. Receipt number also converted, and product name, converted product name. This is absolutely fine. So this is target source 2, okay? So you can have another also, right? The multicast is like one and many outputs it will give, many data flows it will initiate. It no need to be a target, right? Before the target, any of the flows in between any of this data flow, you can add this step so that one flow will have that particular logic, and here this flow will have the another logic. This is also possible using the multicast. So this is the main purpose of multicast. One input, the output, whatever it receives, it will be in many targets. One more interesting thing you need to understand is, like, when you click on it, this will not have multiple outputs. Like, one is the proper output. What about this red is like a failure output. When there is some error happen in this step, this will be flown in this particular step. Here you can see when you click multiple blue outputs, in outputs will be coming, but only one input. Any other transformation doesn't have this multiple blue lines, blue output lines. This is what I want to highlight. This is the multicast. Okay, this is fine. What about the this one, our conditional split? Like, over I said over here, this multicast will run this data. I think we haven't run it. Let us try to run this one. Now one more careful thing you need to understand is, like, this execute SQL task trying to delete only the data at this particular database. So execute SQL task, only one database it is deleting. It is not deleting the another database table. Okay, for that you need to create another execute SQL task, because if it is from same database, you can write another delete statement here. Okay, but it is from another database, you need to create another execute SQL task. What I'm trying to say, let us try to run this package now. Okay, now you can go and see here. Till this point, the let us try to close this one. This one I cannot go it zoomer. Okay, fine. So you can see here the multicast 8161 rows. Here it has distributed to 8161 rows, two flows, right? This is what the intended output of multitask. Now you can go and check here. This is test database, and here it is the SSIS demo, both having a data, but here it is deleting and running, so it will have 8161. Here you see 8169 again. What happens if I run this flow once again, right? Now in SSIS demo, this database, like over here, this will have 8169 only, because we are deleting and reloading 8169. Whereas here, the new database we have created, the table we have created, new database, will increase this size to twice, that is 16318. So that is what I'm trying to highlight. So let us try to replicate it here. Here you need to choose test database, and sales target database is the same. Now you can merge it here. These things we will check it later, I mean the control flow of it. Now when you run it again, both the things will delete the respective databases or tables from different databases. Then this will load into two different databases. This is what I want to explain. Now if you go and see, it will not triple. Instead, it will have only 8169 rows. Here again, SSIS demo, 8169 rows. This is how you can control the flow, and then you can respect your objects you want to load. So what about the conditional split, right? Let us assume, like here in this flow, I do not want to load all the data. I want to load only the Chennai data in my target, that is the newly created source in our newly created target, that is in this database, the test database. I do not wish to load all the data. I want to load only the Chennai data or Bangalore data. Let us go for Bangalore data. I want to load only Bangalore data. So how much row it is, select where Bangalore, sorry, not Bangalore, I need to put location equals, I'll take a copy of it. Okay, so let us have this count that is 22725. Okay, only these rows to be loaded here. That is what I want. Just for your understanding, I put it here. So I remove that query 2725. So only 2725 rows should be loaded. You're not telling this 2725 rows. You are selling the logic like load only the Bangalore. Okay, so like that conditional split conditions you can write it here. So how you can write it using a conditional split. So in this flow you are loading only the Bangalore data. That logic you need to write. So how you can write, this is similar to your derived column that we have seen before. So here you need to choose the location equals Bangalore. Okay, so whatever, this is case one. You can write multiple cases. This will also give multiple outputs. Okay, so case one, case two. Let's see, you want to add I think it's double equals to equals to equals to. You can write another case over here, like location equals Chennai. So you want to load Chennai in some other database and Bangalore in some other database. That is also possible here. So I have written Chennai and Bangalore. I want to use only the case one. Case two and other things I will ignore it. So here when you use target, it will prompt you which case you want to load it here. I want to use case one. Case one is nothing but your Bangalore. Click on OK. Now the mapping will be done automatically over here. So this conditional split, again this can be used anywhere from your source to your targets. So basically once you are getting the data from your source, then you are splitting. Only this particular data had to be loaded. Based on some condition become true, that flow is chosen. You can have another flow also here, that is for Chennai, but for time being I'm not focusing on that. Excuse me. So let us try to load only the Bangalore data, that is case one here. Then let us try to execute it. It's success. Now you can see only 2725, which is we have queried last time, it has been loaded in our target. Our target is nothing but your test database. Let us go and check it in test database. This is my target. Let's run it. 2725, only Bangalore data will be loaded. Whereas again you can see in the SSIS demo all the entire data will be loaded. So I hope you understand the concept behind the multicast and the conditional split. It is not necessarily you need to use here from your flow, or you can choose from you can remove all these steps. You can add a conditional split here, one for Chennai here, one for Bangalore here in different databases. That is also fine. This is what a multicast and conditional split is all about. If you like this video, share with your friends, comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.